What's up, Coda people? There is an application in Slack called a birthday bot, a full-blown application that different teams use. I'm going to show you how to remake that from scratch in about 5 minutes inside of Coda. So let's go. All right, so here's the steps that I'm gonna walk you through and the things you're gonna learn with me today. First, we're gonna generate a core table for team birthdays. We're gonna calculate current birthdays using some formulas. We're gonna set up the Slack connection and generally show you how to use the pack. We're gonna learn how to make personalized message using something called a compose column. And then lastly, we're gonna look at some automations to run our birthday bot. So let's start and make that core table for team birthday. So here you have a table. It's simply two columns, team and birthday, but we are going to need to, of course, calculate their current birthday for the current year. So that's gonna be easy. We're gonna make a new column. We can call this current birthday. And we're gonna make it a formula. I always like to make formulas by clicking on the column header and button. It's a shortcut that gets you there much faster. Once you're there, we are going to create a date. All we wanna do is take the year, right? If this person was born on June 29th, 1984, we're gonna change the year to the current year. So many ways to do that. The easiest is simply a date constructor using the date formula. We're gonna say the year is today.year. We don't wanna put 2024 because then in 2025, you're gonna have to come change it. So instead we'll put today.year. That will always ensure that as the years pass, this always stays up to date. And of course the month we want is the birthday. That takes the birthday row and we can grab its month. And we can do the same thing for day, birthday row.day, okay? All right, so now we have their current birthday in the current year. Perfect. Next up, what we're gonna need to do is create Slack, or connect our Slack pack. So let's do that now. There's a lot of ways to do that. You could go insert and packs and find it here, but I'm gonna show you a quicker way to get there. Our end goal here, remember, is that we are sending a birthday message, okay? So let's create another column, or create a column. And that column is going to be send birthday message to Slack. Okay, I can even make that a little bit longer so we can see it all. There we go, good to go. All right, so we're gonna change the column type on here. Select this, change column type to a button. And that button is going to, on click, it's going to send message or notify user. What that does is it gives me the opportunity to send this notification as multiple things, a notification, Gmail, or Slack. We're choosing Slack. All right, so you'll notice that when I do this, it allows me to add the pack. I haven't done that yet, so let's add the pack to the doc. You'll see that as I add that to the document, now I have a couple modes here on my Slack pack, mode private or shared. For this case, we are gonna try to send a general birthday message to a channel. So we're gonna have this be shared. That's also gonna need to be shared in order for an automation to push it later on. So now let's connect an account. We haven't done that yet. If you've never connected an account, you won't see anything here. You'll see add a new account. I've already connected different accounts. I have personal ones, but I'm gonna use one called SimpliBot. This is actually a kind of like general Slack account that our team has made for these kind of code notifications. That's a really good practice you can make with your Slack ones. So let's go there. Once that's done, I can start creating a simple message here, a personalized message, right? We could say, hey there team, it's, and this is where we can use our at symbol to grab information from the row. It's names, birthday. Let's celebrate them. So now I've got my content. You can continue to personalize this with emojis or more information, right? But next up, last thing we really have to do is just set the channel or the email, all right? So you'll do this if it's gonna go to the general channel. You kind of want this, you know, name by name. If it was general, if you had a different channel, you could call it birthday. But we're just gonna send ours to a general channel, okay? All right. Amazing. So a couple more things we need to do. You do not want your users to have to come in here and press this automatically. We want this to run in the background and automate all the time. So first off, what we need to do is we need to disable these buttons if not the current day. So we're going to go back into the column options and we are going to go into the advanced section, scroll down and disable if. Okay. I'm going to say disable if I'm gonna make it a formula, and we're gonna say current birthday is not equal to today. Okay, there we go, and I'm filming this on May 1st, so you'll see that if I change this to May 1st, we should see that button open up. Great, that's exactly what we want to happen. Lastly now, to automate this, that it will press actually on that day. So in your document settings, if you go down to the fourth section, you're gonna find automations. You're gonna press that, add a rule that is, we can call this send birthday message. All right, and then we are going to do it a time-based trigger. We're gonna repeat every single day. You can choose your time. If there was nothing to press, right? If this was 5-2, boom, there's nothing to press. So this automation can run and it's not gonna do anything because there's nothing we can actually press. But we want the then to be press buttons. The buttons we want to press is, well, the send birthday message button. We're gonna turn that on. You can test it right now and you can see if I test this rule, no action is taken. But if I change this back to 5-1, you'll see that I can send this message. And it didn't find the name of the channel. I got my channel name wrong. I think it's called General Biz in my company. All right, let's send that. One Slack message sent. Amazing. So now you can see that Slack message right here, that sent. You could just put this automation on every day and that is your birthday bot. Got questions? How we could extend this? Put them in the comments below.